Hello everyone, welcome back to Mappenhausen. I'm here with Rick. Hello Rick, I hear you somewhere there.
Howdy, howdy.
And it's just you and I and Squirrely today. All busy weekend, busy. So, our plan for today is firing up this new modded harvester. And we're going to, unfold it first. we're going to clear off 45. Oh my gosh, hurry up and unfold, damn it. We're going to clear off 45 and collect the straw, and then we are going to cultivate that field. Well, we'll get the straw off and then cultivate it, and what we want to do, what we want to do with this field is we're going to get some buildings on here. So we may get some modded buildings for that, specifically for storing root crops like beets and potatoes, and we want to also be able to store TMR. I don't think we have a storage for that right now, so I'm not sure if we'll store it at the end of 26 or if we'll just set up something over here. It's kind of out of the way, but I mean, we're just dropping it off with the what would we do? Would we drop that off with a mixing wagon? I guess so, and then pick it up with a truck, something like that. I don't know, we'll figure it out. We'll do probably that part off screen, but for starters, we need to clear this field off, and then we'll, once we've cleared that off, we can get the field kind of stripped off, and then we'll plow and cultivate, and get all the buildings in and stuff, figure where our roadways are going to be, and then seed the resting grass, I imagine. So, we'll probably want to, before plowing, probably want to throw some muck or something down.
Yeah, probably so.
I don't know if it matters. So we got the barley, some late night harvesting. I guess I should get my lights on. I'll run GPS after I get around a couple times. Mm-hmm. And Squirrely's doing some manure on one of the fields. Okay. So he's working on the manure. He's been busy on the server this week. Mm-hmm. More headland wolves. Try not to run into the trees. Yeah, not gonna be sad to see. It's another fenced-in field, and boy, having these crops right up against the fence sure is difficult. To clear off.
Yeah, yeah.
I think you spend so much time messing around that I don't know if it's worth it. I don't know if we'd be better off just, plowing short of it, putting a row of 3 meters of grass around, all the way around or something. I mean, we lose a little bit of crop, but, oh well. This will make it easier down this end. Yeah, so I considered doing some logging today, but didn't have a lot of prep time today, so we do have a plan here, so that kind of worked out in our favor there. Settle down. Almost took off through the cornfield or the wheat barley field without being set up for it. Let's see. Stick a new GPS. Auto width. Rotate this around. And there, we're good to go. And I can look around the cab while it's on GPS. I'm getting pretty full. I don't know if I'll get to the end or not.
Your pipe is on the...
Yep. I'll just have to back around, do 180 degrees here and back around. Be like that guy with the corn harvester, wait until it's full and then slam on the brakes and get showered in corn. What a derp. Oh, looks like I might make it. I didn't take a full cut here, so I should get back to the end. I just threw the GPS in quickly. I didn't bother fussing with it too much. It only matters for the first and the last pass anyway. Mm-hmm. Plus it worked out. I mean, I planned it this way so I wouldn't get full. And yeah, that's my story and I'm sticking to it. And then I went and told everybody, so yeah, that was pretty dumb of me. Should I... Oh, that's the straw. Alright, Rick, I'm gonna back around to you. There we go. We got this. Easy peasy.
Wanted to try the overloader wagon. I hadn't tried one yet.
Yeah, I always mean to, and I never get to it. I just... I did see that you can use the forge harvester and chop chaff into it, and then use it. So basically, you use it as a, I don't know what you'd call it, the tipper on the back of it, and then you can go dump into a truck. So you don't have to.
Oh, okay.
That would be pretty slick. Assuming it works. And oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. I can't remember who mentioned it. Gonna bug me now. I'm sorry, it's been so long since your comment, I can't remember who it was who said it. I feel bad now. I feel bad for the whole day, so hopefully that'll console you, whoever you are. Or just comment on this video and let everybody know who it was. Hawk. Yep, so it's a busy, busy Saturday. Everybody's busy. Except for Squirrely Rick and I, who have no lives. Right, Rick? These mirrors are not particularly effective. Well, so I've been playing a lot of American Truck Simulator. Oh, a lot, but... you know, a couple runs a day. It's pretty fun, but boy, it sure seems like... I don't know, it's been a while since I played Euro Truck, but it sure seems to be better polished than the game. Maybe that's the whole grass is greener, I don't know. But the fact that you can only pick four trucks, that kind of sucks. But, I mean, a truck is a truck, I suppose, if you're not really an enthusiast, and I'm not, so... I know of the brands, I don't know of any of the model names or anything like that, so I guess I'm not a fan, but it would be nice to have a little more variety. Oh well, DLC I suppose, or mods.
I think they were hoping to get licenses.
I gotcha. Because there are a lot of American truck makers, like American brands, or brands available in North America. Oh well. Kind of hoping we'll be driving into Canada at some point. Rick, if you go straight forward, I'll back up next to you.
This is the...
Thor! It's a red trailer! Oh well, can't win everyone. Alright, that's doing the right frame rate. Doesn't seem to affect it. So glad they fixed the lighting in this. Well, that's one thing I noticed in ETS, is there's so much chrome on the truck. In real life, I would, if it had chrome, I would be like, can I get it in paint? Just because the reflections and... So, in the game, of course, it's... I suppose maybe I could turn down the settings or something to reduce the reflections, but it seems to be eating my frame rate a little. Having a... Especially because, I mean, it does reflect accurately, except, for instance, the air cooler on the Peterbilt, on the, you know, the older style truck. The top part of that is chrome, and you can actually see behind you and use it like a mirror, except it sees through the truck and trailer and doesn't show other vehicles. So it's just, that's kind of wonky, but... I think Squirrelly is getting nervous. That Hitman. I saw what he did to Mike with our harvester. I'm running. Oh, actually, that was a tractor and a baler, I think. I can't remember. Barreling across the field over and ran into him. I don't think he's ever forgiven me for that one. That's okay. I'm not worried. He really has forgiven me, I'm sure. I like these little class harvesters. They're kind of nice. Guess I should show them a little more here. Oh my gosh, I have demonic eyes. I can see them shining. Starfield eyes. Yeah, that's it, because I love farming. Yeah, there you go. Speaking of which, I'm doing that today. Just telling Rick off screen, here in my yard, I bought a large property, well, large for me, 47 acres, and it was all forested. So, to build a house, whoops, what am I doing here? Why can't I? There we go. To build a house, I had to clear a spot, so I had a couple acres cleared of trees there, and our neighbors, one of our neighbors, she has a chemical sensitivity, so if we burned, burned the stumps and all that, which they did. I mean, our neighbors did anyway, but they weren't here at the time. So, by rights, we could have, but we chose not to. We had the person who cleared our spot here pile all the rocks and the stumps and the trees and all the debris all in just a big pile in the back corner of the lot. And so after about, I don't know, 5-6 years, something like that, I went in with my backhoe and pulled it all apart. So basically I just started pulling out stumps and putting them aside and got three or four huge piles of dirt from it. And then, so we've slowly been, well, we've been gardening in those mounds, which work pretty well. We cover them with hay to act as mulch, keep the weeds down, and then we would plant potatoes and stuff like that in them. So that's last few days we've been going through one of the piles, and so I take a scoop with the hoe on the backhoe, like the backhoe, and pick it up, and then we slowly dump it out and go through it and get the rocks, and the pile I'm dumping on is, you know, kind of a peaked pile, so all the rocks go to the outside, so they're easy to rake up, and then scoop them up with the hoe of the backhoe and dump them in a wheelbarrow, and then dump them over the bank nearby. So anyway, the whole point of that is just clearing out all the rocks, and there were a lot, almost half of the dirt was rocks. And so that's what we've been doing for a few days, and so all that dirt will be for potatoes. I need to come a little closer there, Rick. Closer, I won't bite. Oh. So, kind of farming. It's like a giant rototiller. Well, giant for our use. I mean, our gardens are tiny. We use a little gas rototiller. That's how small our gardens are, but spread everywhere. So, reclaimed all that dirt that normally people would have burned all that. Oh, look at that. There's a little bit of barley there. I want to grab it because I don't want it showing up. And so most people would have burned all that and lost a lot of that. It just would have broken down the carbon. I guess it wouldn't really be lost, but you would think it'd be it's practically free dirt, except I had to run the backhoe for all that, so that took some fuel, of course, but certainly cheaper than hiring somebody to do it. And I think it was cheaper than, you know, going and buying a load of topsoil. Topsoil is really expensive, plus then somewhere else is being denuded for that topsoil, so at least we're reclaiming the dirt that was already here is just getting mounted up in the gardens now, so that's kind of neat. So over the years of gardening in it, it went from crappy old forest soil that's mostly rock to now it's really good dirt, and we've mixed in a bit of sand that we had left over from our septic when we put that in, and so the potatoes seem to like the sand, bit of gravelly and stuff. Ooh, now how's that for a soliloquy story? We
almost got you through the field.
Mm-hmm. You got any farming stories for us, Rick?
Not any lately.
Well, what's your favorite farming thing to do in real life?
You mean other than eating what I picked?
Well, other than sitting back and eating what you picked, yes.
I don't know. I enjoy all of it.
Are there parts you don't like? Like mucking out animals, or do you probably don't do that, do you?
I haven't known for quite a while.
Just field stuff.
Yeah, mostly go to pick your own places here lately.
I think more people need to go to those. I mean, even if you don't have a farm of your own, just to have local farms where you can go and pick your food and at a reduced cost, but just being able to go and see, you know, this is where it's grown and how it's grown and have some idea where your food comes from. I think that's pretty important.
Yeah, and it's, you know, fresh food is best.
That is for sure. Go off this edge here. Well, nah, I guess it doesn't matter.
I have family that does some farming sometimes. They'll put it in what they call a garden. Yeah. It's planted with a 5 series John Deere. So.
It's a big one, is it?
No, 5 series, it's a kind of general purpose, they call them.
Bigger than a lawn tractor.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's taller than I am, I put it that way.
And what are they usually planting?
Oh, he's got some sugar cane. They like to make syrup in the fall.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, various types of beans.
Okay, I'll finish this and then unload the rest. Yeah, beans,
peas,
yeah,
corn, okra, squash, cucumbers, yeah, a little bit of everything.
Well, that's the best. Polyculture is the way to go. My opinion.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only opinion I have, is my own. We've been buying packs of beans, like just like two or five pound bags. It's the biggest we can get here, and then putting them in what's it called, the Mylar bags, and then putting them in buckets and storing them. So that's our emergency food, so we've been doing that, and just started getting in the canning, so we canned some chicken, so we're going to do some more of that. Worked pretty well. We tested some, and it was delicious. I mean, it just tastes like, well, we put some bullion in with it just to kind of reduce how, you know, so if we had to, for whatever reason, take it straight out of the bottle and eat it, then it would have some flavor other than just boiled. Chicken flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Oops, I just dumped some green on you there. Anyway, it's really good. I'm pretty impressed. Happy we purchased the canner and It wasn't a really expensive one. It was a Presto, so $100 and some Canadian, so it's not terribly expensive. We looked at the All-American, it was a lot more money though. A really nice machine, or a nice canner, but it would have been more work to clean and stuff because it was heavier. So harder on the hands cleaning, that sort of thing. So we weren't really going to gain enough from it to justify the expense. Alright, so I'll take this. Oops, where's my button here? Nope, wrong button. This back and dump it in the yard and go and get a tractor and plow. So I've been putting out Factorio videos like there's no tomorrow for a week. Can't believe we're up to episode 40 I recorded and released today. So that's 4 weeks, that's 10 weeks I've been making that. It just seems like I just started. Anyway. Christopher Lee has been helping me a lot with my quality, so I think it's my videos have gotten better, so thanks to him. I don't know if he watches this, but my thanks to him for his suggestions and improving the quality of the video. Doing the jump cuts and stuff like that, so if you like those, that was his doing. If you don't like those, well, you can complain at him. Oh, we got dolly trailers, and I don't think my header's parked on there very well. That's good enough. Okay, so now for the fun part. I guess with the harvester, you know what, I'm just not even going to park this on screen. I want to keep going. I'm just leaving it in the middle of the yard. All right, so let's grab a tractor. What do we got? Need something with a little more horsepower. You're done with that one, are you? And that's this one.
Got a load of straw I need to go dump.
Alright, so I need a plow. Where's the plow? Oh, wow, it was dark and raining a few minutes ago, and by the end of this episode, it's bright and sunny, and I can't see my screen.
Did you want to put slurry down?
I don't think so. You know what? When we're all done, if we want to, like, we're gonna see grass around there, but if we want to actually harvest,
for any kind of harvest, so
yeah. But if we do decide to, at least it's been plowed and it's, and we can start just start spraying it if we want to harvest it.
Okay. Still got a little bit more straw to get.
I imagine this is gonna be a pretty big parking lot there. We need to get some bigger equipment, and we need a place to put it, so that's what this is for here. And this is nice central. Where are we here on the map? This is about as central as you can get on this map. Well, no it isn't. I guess we could... 26 would be, but... So by rights, what we could do is up at the end of 26, do it all up there. Now I'm having second thoughts, Rick. Yeah, where we're at's good. This will be fine. Okay, so I guess I best get started here instead of just cruising around looking cool in my case. Seems I keep ending up back in this tractor. It's not on purpose. I think we need to get some bigger tractors. Especially with $2.5 million in the bank. Well, let's look at tractors. Maybe it's time for a bigger tractor for plowing. We'll go with this. Yeah, right. We're not going to go to the biggest right off the bat, are we, Rick? I know Mike has been pretty interested in the Challenger. 314,000. What do you say we buy that? What do you think?
Sound like a plan.
Engine setup. 385, 411. All right. Well, we got lots of money, so boom, purchased. Sorry, Case, you gotta go home. We got bigger fish to fry with. So, unplanned purchase. Mike will be excited, though. He's been really talking about that nut tractor. We'll just dump this in here. So long, Case. I'm done with you now. With your big balloon tires. Let me see. Now we've got. Where's the forklifts? There we are. Aha! It's a beastie thing. Needs a turret on the top, though. 105mm cannon, yeah, that's the way to go. Oh, wow, it turns. Whoa, almost hit the forklift. It turns sharp. Look out, townspeople, I'm coming through. Ah, well, I don't care. If I run over any of the... So what, they'll respawn. Got any options on this thing? Oh no, it's vanilla, never mind. And the squirrely sees this. Oh, I can't even steer it. Whee! Oh my, sorry everybody. I heard one of you throw up there. I'm sorry. I was spinning in circles. Wait, it was me. Can't see in this. Oh, it's too dark. We'll have to see it by the light of day. Well, let's see, we're gonna switch that over here. Cut in from the side. Actually, I'm gonna change my mind again. We'll cut in the other way.
Do you want me to get the little one and do the edges?
Sure, if you like. If that's the case, I don't even have to go to the edge. I can just leave that for the little one, couldn't I? Just do the bulk of it with this. Beep, 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 backing up. Alright, well, let's get some GPS action on this thing. Brand new tractor, we need to put GPS on it. So we want a new... Turn it to approximately edge of the field, I think. Whoops, too much. There we go. Now this has an offset on it. Is that going to offset the correct way? That's the question. What's the width on this thing? Any idea? Top of your head? Let's plow.
9 point.
Nine point something? I'm looking too. I can't see plows, but I'm just blind right now. Oh, there we go. That's the Lemkin we've got, so that's...
9.6.
The Lemkin plow is 4.9. 9.6 Appian.
I'm sorry, yeah. I'm looking at the wrong thing.
Cultivator or something. Gee, I was over at the store. I should have bought a new plow, too. Oh, well. Oh, well. Oh, my gosh, and I forgot what I said. What was the...
4.9.
Losing my mind. Okay, 4.9. Thanks. So we'll put that then to 4.8. There. Oh, my gosh, what a derp. I don't know how you can stand me. Just have to live with it. Okay, let's get our GPS down to 16. Or our speed down to 16. Well, it's having no problem pulling this. I'll turn off those beacons. It's actually plowing a little further than the box, but that's okay. Let's see what it does going the other way. Yes, I think we need a little bit more room down here. I think I might have broken the plow a bit there too. Might have hit it on the back of the track a little. Not very much. Not enough to require serious surgery, but might be a little bit of welding, a little bit of bending. Oops, did I not reverse that? Oh, I don't have the offset reset, or reverse. Reverse the offset and put on automatic, reverse it again, there we go. Darn kerp. My gosh, this thing is crazy to turn. It has a hard time staying on GPS. Oh, wiggles all over the place. Oh my gosh, this may not be usable. There we go.
Was it acting like a...
It acted like the Kurvitz used to.
Yeah.
But once you get going straight, it seems okay. Oh man. So, I guess if I was going the other way, then this would turn a little better for me for going this direction across the field. Well. A lot of messing around at the end of the field. Well, to tell you, those things turns on a dime. I have to keep it in the air just for parking stuff. Oh my gosh. Except it's still taking me some getting used to try and get the plow set up. Yeah, so we'll get this field plowed and then cultivated, and we'll get some buildings on it, and make out a yard on it, and then grass the rest, and we'll have that for next episode to show. You'd look at some buildings, specifically one that would hold TMR and also some little covered things for the root crops, right?
Mm-hmm.
So maybe give those a shot and see how they go on the server.
Maybe they'll work good.
Mm-hmm.
They're pretty handy.
Maybe they'll work well, or maybe... Well, a second here. Maybe it won't. We'll see. You never know with Farm Sim server.
Mm. There is that.
The turning on this is insane. I'm just having a hard time getting this thing to go where I want.
Kind of all over more than any place else.
Let's go a little bit here, and there we go. We're fine. It's an oddly shaped field. It's because of the field. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it, Rick.
Sounds good to me.
Now, where did Squirrely get off to? Oh, I think he's probably parking the harvester. Thanks, Squirrely. I think he's... Oh, he was in it. Is he still in it? Know what he's doing. Yeah, he's parking the trailer. Good, good. Not that I can't do it, it's just I'd still be... Well, I would have finished it by now, but... We probably wouldn't have bought this tractor. We wouldn't have had time. Speaking of time, we were about out of it a few minutes ago. We kept going a little bit. Oh well. Had to show a little bit of the tractor. So, next time, did I reverse this? I think I did. Yeah. Never had. Alright, there we go. So, next time we'll hopefully have some new sheds and some more mods added in. Not sure what ones, but we'll see what we've got. And also have something done here and something nice and special and very nice. Nice. right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good answer. So, thanks so much for joining us.
See you later, guys.
Bye for now.